movie has been rated PG by the Motion. The following movie has been rated PG by the Motion Picture Association of America. Parental guidance is suggested.
It's party time. Oh, it's party time. Having a party. Come.
Live from Pacific Quay, it's another quality broadcast from the BBC.
It's Friday, 2nd of February. I'm the home of Trump.
Until everybody you know, it's the Ashley Story Show. Go tell everybody you know, it's the Ashley Story Show. Come for the music and stay for the sparkling wit. Silent for days, alright, let's get on with it. Go tell everybody you know, it's the Ashley Story Show.
I'm Ashley Storrie. You're listening to BBC Radio Scotland live from Pacific Quaver. And we are talking crisps tonight with sidekick Silent Paul. Hello, Silent Paul. How are you this week?
I'm all right.
We're talking crisps. We're talking potato chips for our American listeners. Maybe a corn snack. What's your favourite crisp, Paul?
Ooh, right, it's not a potato one anyway.
Oh, shocker.
Straight off the bat would never be it. I honestly like cheap 10 pence crisps.
Yeah.
And if I had to say my favourite, probably Space Raiders.
Oh, I like a... No, I do like a Space Raider.
Like, you just, like, you would eat them all. Like,
oh,
you
know, you get seven in a packet.
You know how you get the multi-packs?
Yeah.
And then before you know it, you've just emptied the full multi-pack into a bowl and just eat the whole bowl.
Such a waste of plastic, but yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about.
Yeah, they should just sell them in a big pack.
They should sell tubs of Space Raiders like they do in America with cheese puffs.
Sorry, can I stop you right here? See if you look into the studio next door into Radio Nangale. There's a man that looks exactly like me.
Is he your reflection?
No, it's not.
It's
definitely 100% not.
I am so glad you were looking through that window, because see from here it looks like you're looking at the side of my head, and I thought there's a spider on my head.
Yeah.
There's a spider
there's
on
a
my
man.
Head. He does look... There is a man with tall, greying hair, glasses, and a penchant for a geography teacher jumper sitting in the next room, like an almost through the looking glass moment. I wonder if there's
anyway, sorry, I just derailed that whole conversation. Ashley, what's your favourite crisp?
Oh my goodness, I can't believe he's asking my opinion on something. This never happens. A ridged crisp, Paul. I like a ridged crisp. Salt and vinegar, a prawn cocktail, anything that's got a sort of piquant nature. I don't like a dull, meaty flavour. I like something, a razzle-dazzle on my tongue.
I would agree. Something that strips taste buds off, and if you eat too much of it, it starts to hurt the sides of your lips.
Hurts the side of my lips, hurts the gum-tooth connection part, because it's also sharp. Like, I like a sharp crisp.
Not too sure about that.
I like my teeth having to work, Paul. It's very important. Get in touch via text 80295. Let us know your favourite type of crisp. Let us know what crisps from the olden days that are no longer about you'd bring back. And here is my third question that I didn't ask on the internet. This is just for the listeners. I want to know your crisp alternatives, because there's adjacents. There's crisp alts that aren't necessarily a crisp.
But are in the same aisle.
A pita chip. I think would fall into
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I think that. I think
a root vegetable crisp. Oh, like, I love a beetroot crisp.
The beetroot ones are the best.
The beetroot ones are the best, but they're the ones that you have to put a little note on your phone, on your alarm for the next morning saying, hey, just a reminder, you ate beetroot crisps, you're not dying. Because every time I eat them, I forget. And then I spend a good 20 minutes on the NHS 24 website querying why my poo's red. Mm. And then I remember and then I go, oh, you silly sausage, you've done it again. But let us know. We want to know about your favourite crisps and your crisp adjacent snacks. Would a nut? A these
no,
nuts?
These nuts?
Would they fall into a crisp? I feel like a nut would.
Kinda. I have. But then we're getting into, do we allow dried corn snacks?
Yes, of course you do.
and then, or boxes of like chickpeas, dried things. I love a wasabi mix.
Oh, yes. I think anything you could serve on a bowl at the temperature it's brought in from a bag counts. If it comes in a bag, right?
I think if you just buy it in the crisps and snacks aisle, that's what counts.
Yeah, but some people don't buy crisps and snacks. Some people out there make their own, Paul. So we need to account for them. So I'm giving you a wide berth of what constitutes a crisp alternative.
We'll talk about that.
Get in touch with
you. Are you a dips person?
Oh, I'm a dip all the way.
Oh, no, I'm never.
I make dips. I make tzatziki. I make hummus.
As dry as possible.
No, I like a well-weighted crisp that you can scoop up a whole meal with.
No.
Like, I'll eat a salad with crisps instead of a knife and fork. And that's the only way you're getting meat in a salad. You're laughing. This is a thing, Paul. This is like a trend of how to get people like me who are children with children mouths to eat salads, and it's using crisps as cutlery.
There you go.
There you go.
Mind blown.
Now,
do you want to tell people how they can get in touch?
I said 80295 and I keep looking at you to do the email and the WhatsApp.
You're supposed to just direct it to me.
Oh, Paul. How else can people get in touch with us?
Get in touch via WhatsApp and 08 85 92 95 00.
Uh-oh.
That's for international listeners. That's for everyone, I think. Anywhere you can get WhatsApp. Oh, know what to do. You can send pictures
of your crisps
on WhatsApp. What are you snacking on watching the show?
What's your snack? Let us know. And you can email us.
Yes, it's ashleystoryshow@bbc.co.uk.
Jim in Netherley's been in touch and says, Ashley, I have to start with a humble apology. Last week, I genuinely never caught Paul's napalm joke in the Hollywood Swingers opening, so I went into my full pun mode and was chuffed with my joke. If I had known that Paul had cracked it, I'd never have sent it in. Situation wasn't helped by Ashley using it for full-on comedy wind-up mode. I remain traumatised as being the cause of your wee domestic.
Do you know
However,
what?
I have got a book deal from it. Robert Duvall is part of my downfall. Yours in full apology, Jim and Netherley.
Takes a big man to admit when they're wrong.
Big man to admit, Jim and Netherley. And you don't have to admit anything because your joke was better and Paul's was rubbish. And if you didn't pick up on it, then that's his fault and not yours. Now, we all enjoy different flavours of crisps, cheese and onion, salt and vinegar, and salted, ready or not.
Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. Gonna find you and take it slowly. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. Gonna find you and make you want me.
Now that I escape, sleep, walk away. Those who correlate know the world ain't kick. Jail bars ain't golden gates. Those who fake, they break. When they meet their 400-pound mate, if I could rule the world, everyone would have a gun in the ghetto, of course. When get the up and on their horse, kick a rhyme, drinking moonshine. I pour a sip on the concrete for the deceased, but no, don't weep. Why Clef's in a state of sleep, thinking about the robbery that I did last week. Money in the bag, banker look like a drag. I wanna play with pelicans from here to Baghdad. Gun blast, think fast, I think I'm hit. My girl pinched my hips to see if I still exist. I think not, I'll send a letter to my friends. A born again hooligan, only to be king again.
Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. Gonna find you and take it slowly. Ready or not, here I come. Gonna find you and make you want me. I play my enemies like a game of chess where I rest. No stress if you don't smoke cess. Less, I must confess, my destiny's manifest. In some vortex and sweats, so I make tracks like I'm homeless. Rap orgies with Borgie and Bess. Capture your bounty like Elliot Ness. Yes, bless you if you represent the fool. But I hex you with some witches brew. If you do do voodoo, I could do what you do. Believe me, frontin' chicken, it be heebie-jeebie. So why you imitating Al Capone? I be needing Simone and defecating on your microphone. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. Gonna find you and take it slowly. You can't run away from these stars I got, oh baby. Hey,
Refugee taking over. The Buffalo Soldier, dreadlock roster. On the 12th hour, fly by in my bomber. Crews run for cover, now they under pushing up flowers. Super fly, true lies do or die. Toss me high, only puff fly with my crew from like high. I, refugee from Guantanamo Bay. Dance around the border like I'm Cassius Clay.
Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide.
Nobody.
Gonna find you. Slowly, ready or not, here I come. You can't hide.
Hey, yo, nobody move.
Gonna find you and take it slowly. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide.
Hey, yo, nobody move.
Gonna find you and make you
come on.
Want me. Ready or not, here I come.
That was the Fugees with Ready or Not. We're talking crisps. Andrew in Falkirk says, I shall have to listen on the app just in case anyone crunches one and I can skip the sound. Andrew in Falkirk, Paul did crisp a crunchy crisp in the opening to the show.
But that's it.
We will not be doing any more eating. Oh, but I love doing eating sounds. No, it's not a thing for everybody. It's one of those things that grosses folk out. Mm. We get strong feeling on both sides of the fence when we do eating stuff on the radio.
We got it out of our system early on. Hand on heart, Silent Paul, promise, no more crunching of crisps.
No more. Thomas from Austria says, hi Ashley and Paul. Great show so far. I did cut and fry crisps from raw tatties once. Not worth the effort. I know. I've been there, I've done it, it's not great.
Nah. I mean, there's a science to it, and these people who have invested a lot of money and infrastructure to make crisps.
Yeah.
Just let them do their business.
Let them do their business. It's God's work. It's precious work. It's the just, Paul, it's like Willy Wonka. I don't think
trust in the science.
I don't think we appreciate how special a crisp is. Do you know what I mean? You can go into a shop with less than a pound and come away with at least the taste of a roast dinner in your mouth.
Mm-hmm. You can go away. You could go into a shop and come away with the taste of anything in your mouth.
That's magic. Like,
yes.
That's exciting.
Uh-huh.
And the fact that we don't praise it enough is sad.
Like, Willy Wonka's all like, oh, look, you can lick this wallpaper. You're like...
The schnozberries taste like schnozberries.
You don't need to. You can just go and buy a packet of crisps and get the same effect.
You can just smear jam on your wall and lick it if that's what you want to do. If you want to lick was and taste a schnozberry. But being able to walk in to a small shop and come away with a lamb and mint roast.
You could actually make a roast dinner out of crisps. You could just get like roast beef or roast chicken crisps, right?
Right.
And then vegetable crisps.
Right.
With like, there's your parsnips
no.
And there's your sweet potato.
This is
and they're
wild.
All potatoes anyway.
Have you ever used crisps in cooking?
No.
Crunchy top pastas, lasagna.
No. Not from, no.
Macaroni cheese.
No, they have.
I'm telling you, Paul.
They have their place and it's separate.
When I make cornflakes chicken, I will crunch in a bag of Doritos in there.
Nah, I don't like this.
Oh,
I've seen
I literally
do it.
Made
not...
it the other day. A Crunchwrap Supreme on my own because I always get sore tummy.
A Crunchwrap Supreme is like a kind of wrap from a certain Mexican food.
So when I buy it from the Mexican food chain, I always end up with a really bad tummy. So I have to make them myself. A facsimile thereof, of it. And you put like crunchy Doritos in that. Oh, it's good, Paul. Oh, it's good.
Yeah, but that's okay because that's just crisps in a sandwich.
So, well then...
I'll put crisps in a sandwich.
It's weird that you're okay with putting crisps in a sandwich but not as a top to a macaroni cheese.
No, because now it's becoming an ingredient and not a topping.
You know, you can rehydrate potato crisps and make mashed potato out of them.
I've seen somebody do it. It's disgusting.
No, it's foul, but it is possible.
It doesn't matter. Whatever's possible doesn't mean you do it.
Alan from Edinburgh has been in touch and said Pringles, salt and vinegar.
Oh,
there is nothing better than the shooting pains through your tongue when you've eaten too many Pringles.
We're going to talk about this all show. Can we just do a blanket other crisps are available for everything we talk about.
I thought since we were talking about all different kind of crisps, I wouldn't have to keep saying other crisps are available, because by
we've
talking
just done
about
a blanket,
crisps...
A blanket agreement covers all.
Other crisps are available. But yeah, salt and vinegar and the Golden Wonder needs to be best. But the Biker's Spicy is the best. Oh, I do love a Biker. Other brands are tasty. From Alan Small in Edinburgh. Get in touch via text 80295. Let us know about your favourite crisps. Do you love? Here's some. Somebody got in touch on Facebook and did say that square crisps should be banned.
Why?
He said they cut your mouth and they don't taste good. And I say that the square crisp is the working man's crisp.
It's
a working class hero crisp. You don't see hoity-toity folk eat a square crisp. You've never seen lords and ladies at Aspic. What's that thing called where they race horses? Not Aspic, that's a jelly.
Do you think it's not like a bit passé to be eating square?
I think it's hip to be square, Paul. Play it.
Take punishment and had to settle down. Now I'm playing it.
That was Hip to Be Square by Huey Lewis and The News. Right, Paul, we've been very UK-centric in our discussion of flavours of potato chips, and we have listeners from all over the world tuning in online and sometimes on catch-up. So first of all, let me talk catch-up, because we were talking DIY last week.
Yes.
And Laura from Vermont got in touch.
Yes.
With a DIY that her and her daughter built, and it's a school bus that they've transformed into a tiny home, and this is phenomenal. It's like something out of The Sims. It's so perfect. I love it. I'm so jealous. I think that's fantastic, and yous have done an absolutely brilliant job. So if you're listening to this show on Listen Again and you want to get in touch and you think, oh, I wish I was involved, but you can't be involved because you're listening again, don't worry, we're still going to see your email and we'll give you a shout out. So if you're listening to this on a Tuesday and you're like, oh, I want to talk about my favourite crisps,
you only ever get to listen to us like when you're in your work on a Wednesday morning, and you're just like, I never get to join in.
No,
just join in.
Join in now.
You can email us, ashleystoryshow@bbc.co.uk, and we'll read out your email.
And let us know what your favourite kind of crisp is. Now, I was having a look for crisps that aren't necessarily, you know, they're not British-centric, they're outside of the world. There's crisps I want to try. There's ones from Singapore that are egg yolk-flavoured crisps.
Yeah, they one sounded good.
But they also come in, like, fish skin. So like
not
salmon,
entirely sure about that.
I think I'd enjoy it because I enjoy fish. I enjoy crunchy fish. You know, like white bait. Have you ever got white bait?
No.
It's like the whole little tiny fried fish.
No.
Head, bones, everything.
No.
Dip and munch.
Nope.
I love them.
No.
They are my favourites. But I was looking, cucumber flavour crisps. Chili and chocolate makes sense. They've got in here, Mackie's did haggis and crackback black pepper. I've eaten them. Those are amazing flavoured crisps. Those taste delish. Kettle Chips did a salted caramel and double cream. Now, the reason I'm going to say these are great, have you ever had Schneider's pretzels?
No, I have eaten pretzels, but not this particular brand.
So Schneider's do like honey mustard pretzels, and they're an American company, and they do a salted caramel pretzel. And it is so good. But while I'm eating it, it's so American. And I can tell it's bad for it. Like, I can tell with every taste, tastes like an indoor play area in a strange way.
Every time you eat it, it's like your blood doesn't feel right.
A wee bit. There's a company here called Tory Selecta who do sparkling wine-flavoured crisps.
Body. I saw one earlier, and it was of a finest variety that was Prosecco-flavoured crisps. That's wrong.
I don't understand why everybody went mad for Prosecco at one point. Do you remember?
Because it was a way of being fancy but cheap.
It was like, do you remember when everybody went mad for like pear cider?
We all just got a wee bit too good for just buying the £4 bottle of wine.
I just couldn't do it. I was like, this tastes like heartburn. Why are we all pretending we enjoyed this? I didn't get. Oh, okay, Australia, a Leamington, and I love. A Leamington, Australia. You've got a lot
right,
of good desserts.
Stop. What's a Leamington?
Oh, right, okay. A Leamington is like a sponge cube, right? It's got jammy outside all round the outside, and it's got coconut on the jam, and it's got like kind of school jam cake energy.
Yeah, you get them here. They're called pink jammies.
No, they're called a Leamington, mate. That's a Leamington.
You get them here. They're pink jammies.
Kiwi or Australian. They're one
but
at a time.
Regardless, it's a terrible flavour.
They're
for
Australasian.
Crisps.
I don't think that's a terrible flavour for crisps. I like the idea of sweet crisps, Paul. What about whiskey and haggis? Another haggis flavoured.
Keep booze out of crisps.
Yeah, there is a lot of booze based crisps. So yeah, if you're listening from far-flung places, or you've been to far-flung places and you've eaten some weird crisps, if you've tried those Singaporean egg crisps, get in touch via text 80295. Let us know all about them. Or you can WhatsApp us. What's the WhatsApp, Paul?
It's 0808592950.
Or you can email us. What is the email, Paul?
ashleystoryshow@bbc.co.uk.
That's exactly what it is. Let's jump to text messages just quickly, because we've got so many in and I want to try and get through as many of them as possible. Brannigan's roast beef and mustard. Standing O. That's a meal in a crisp. Pow. Explosion of heat. Cue Laura, self-control. Great show. I'm from Neil / Wick.
Neil and Wick, probably.
Oh.
No, like Neil Wick. He's not like John Wick's brother.
I don't know John Wick's brother, Neil Wick, who's like...
The Scottish one.
Doug was fine.
Oh, dear. You've killed my sheep.
Oh, no. I'm going to get revenge on you, but after I've had a nap, bye. Neil Wick is a sleepy wick. That's a well-known fact about him.
Roast beef and mustard Brannigans, which you can't get anymore.
Okay.
When you put the first one in your mouth and you're like... And it actually takes your breath away.
Yeah.
And then you're just like, this is now Flavour Town.
No, I know, but do you remember the first time you ate them when you were a kid? You were like, kapow!
I believe that crisps were like this.
It was like your head exploded.
Yes.
It was like a cartoon. It was the best thing ever.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's such a good shout. Right, Paul, you want to do the next segue because it's a really good one.
Sometime.
Guys. Hold Let's your
don't,
breath.
Don't build it up. You're going to ruin it.
This
sometimes,
is so
stop. Sometimes I like to have little soirees and invite over some friends. And, you know, they all like different varieties of crisps.
Who's your favourite former Liverpool player? Little Suarez.
Suarez, yeah. And he'll ask, he's known for chomping, so he likes a hard crisp.
He does like a hard
crisp. So I'll be like, look, there's kettle chips. Just look about, there's plenty of them, get into them. And then there's my pal Alfred, and he likes a nice cheese puff.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm like, I go over and I was like, why the long face? He's like, I can't see any crisps that I like. And I went, what are you talking about? What's this all about, Alfie?
What's it all about?